Hello there, and welcome to the Business Roundup this week. My name is Vailak Sasia, and on set with me is Paul Sharizi, a business journalist with The New Vision. We are conveniently having this interview right after the president spoke about the development in the country, security, and several other issues, but interestingly, the progress of the economy. So we shall be starting with that and several others. Stay with us. All right, so Paul, let's talk about the parish development model. The president said there is progress, actually, that's being registered, but feedback from social media and other concerned citizens says that it's not actually happening. So what is the issue? What's the misunderstanding? And what can you tell us about the progress of the parish development model?
So the parish development model is an attempt to narrow the wealth differences in our country. Government is trying to proactively send the means for everyone to benefit from the growth of the last 30 or so years. The way it's being done is, one, they are supporting cooperatives, they are causing data collection, which is interesting, why we start doing it now and why it wasn't there before, and they are creating production groups trying to organize the farmers into some sort of groups, and also helping them bulk their produce. So the idea being that if 70% of our population derives a livelihood from agriculture, and most of the poverty we see in these countries in the rural areas, it just means that we need to reorganize their production, either, of course, agriculture or the value chain in the rural areas, so that people can get more money. So PDM is an attempt at doing that in various ways.
It's interesting that you mention the statistic that 70% of Ugandans are involved in agriculture, or even more as the years go by. So let's talk about how best we can make this, beneficial for the country. In an event that someone receives part of the 10 million sent to the parishes in the PDM program, how best can we have these farmers then use that money to produce largely for Uganda, knowing that their number is really high that are in agriculture? How best can we stop being needy when it comes to the industry scale in agriculture?
Yes, that's the challenge of this country. We do not produce enough to, for example, sustain industry. President Museveni is talking about, during Women's Day, he talked about raising the people of Western Uganda, Chirhura, into dairy product producers. And he said, and if I'm not wrong, he said 1986, the country was producing about 600,000 liters of milk, and now we're producing 2.8 billion. 600,000 liters of milk was supporting only one industry, which was dairy corporation. Now we have more than 10 milk industries because of volumes. So what has helped in this case is that we've been able to have these milk processing, cooling units spread around the countryside, which provide a market for farmers, and then they can take it to bulking centers or processing factories. Now, in this country, apart from, I think, coffee and milk now, and probably tea, there are very few agricultural products that can support real industry as we understand it, to shift the needle on industry in this country. So it has to start with production, and that's where also the parish development model comes in.
So before we leave the parish development model conversation, let's talk about the president's visit to Algeria. We did see him meet his counterpart while there and several other officials, but interestingly, he always makes tours, but makes sure that they are about developing the economy. So what was part of this visit, and what can we hope for as Ugandans in business?
I know that for a long time, the president has been talking about selling milk to Algeria. So probably, I suspect, they were farming up on such commitments. And the truth of the matter is that if you're going to, like now, during the parish development model, you're going to make your farmers grow more, you've got to create a market for them. I mean, when you try to supply industry, you're using a surplus of your local production. And that, just by definition, suggests that you can't consume it yourself, so you have to have external markets. We know, like, for a while now, Uganda has been exporting to Kenya, but we've had our problems with the Kenyans. Every so often they get annoyed with us. So it's in the quest to find other markets in case the current markets fail. We should do that. But of course, at the center of it is that if we urge the farmers to produce more, we better be able to offtake that, whatever they produce. Otherwise, you know, farmers will just say, rubbish, if I can't sell my thing, I'm not going to do it. They're not stupid.
All right, thank you so much. So we make sure to stay updated on what's happening in business. We shall have you next time, Paul. Thank you. And thank you for making time to watch. We've come to the end. I hope that you had the updates from the world of business, and make sure to catch this every Friday here on the news. I'm Vailak Sasia. I'll see you next time.